Speak Indo Podcast is a medium to think about life while learning about the Indonesian language and culture. Hi, I'm Natasha, the host of Speak Indo Podcast. The first part of the story will be narrated in the Indonesian language. The second part will be in English. The transcript is available on our blog, speakindo.life, and our YouTube, Speak Indo channel. Season 2, Episode 12, Human's Best Friend.
Setelah tinggal di DC selama 4 tahun, pada tahun 1998 saya ingin sekali punya anjing. Pada saat itu, saya rajin riset dan baca buku ensiklopedia khusus buat anjing. Akhirnya saya jatuh hati dengan satu jenis anjing, yaitu Saluki. Tapi karena anjing Saluki tingkat aktivitasnya lumayan tinggi dan saya waktu itu masih sekolah master sambil mulai bekerja, maka saya pendam keinginan untuk memiliki anjing jenis itu. Selain itu, saya juga masih tinggal di apartemen, jadi saya memutuskan untuk memilih jenis anjing yang sesuai dengan gaya hidup saya, yaitu jenis Italian Greyhound yang bentuknya seperti miniatur Greyhound dengan tinggi sekitar 25 cm. Kira-kira saat musim panas tahun 1998, dari hasil riset saya menemukan peternak anjing jenis Italian Greyhound di Nebraska. Anjing pertama saya di Amerika ini saya beri nama Giorgio, nama Italia karena jenisnya Italian Greyhound. Sekitar 8 hingga 10 bulan kemudian, saya putuskan untuk punya anjing satu lagi dengan jenis yang sama. Dan saya kasih nama Giacomo, yang waktu itu kira-kira sudah berusia 4-5 tahun. Tahun 2004, saya pindah ke rumah di daerah Columbia Heights, DC. Di tahun 2005, anjing saya Giacomo didiagnosa dengan masalah tiroid. Akhirnya, tahun 2005, sekitar bulan Maret, anjing saya Giacomo meninggal. Jelas saya dan Giorgio sedih. Akhirnya, pada saat musim panas, saya mulai cari anjing satu lagi. Saluki yang pernah ada di benak saya muncul kembali. Saya riset online dan saya menemukan peternak anjing jenis ini di daerah Kansas. Hadirlah Osmar, anjing Saluki berwarna putih di dalam kehidupan saya. Saluki adalah jenis anjing yang mempunyai naluri untuk berburu dengan menggunakan mata, dibandingkan dengan penciuman seperti anjing lain pada umumnya. Jenis anjing ini bisa lari dengan kecepatan 64 hingga 80 km per jam. Dalam sejarah, anjing Saluki ini sudah ada kira-kira sejak 7.000 tahun yang silam di daerah Persia. Makanya anjing jenis ini banyak dipelihara oleh orang di daerah Timur Tengah atau Asia Barat sampai saat ini. Yang pertama memelihara anjing Saluki adalah suku Bedouin, yaitu suku asli bangsa Arab yang hidup di gurun dan selalu berpindah. Anjing ini bertubuh ramping dan berkaki panjang dengan tinggi sekitar 70 cm. Dedikasi dan komitmen saya dengan Saluki lumayan tinggi. Saya tinggal di kota besar dan bukan berarti saya bisa bawa Osmar ke tempat yang tanpa pagar dan saya biarkan lari. Karena kalau dia melihat misalnya tupai, nalurinya untuk menangkap besar sekali. Paling tidak sehari dua kali, setiap hari, dalam cuaca apapun, harus saya bawa ke taman khusus anjing dalam jam yang tidak ramai. Taman anjing selalu berpagar tinggi, jadi saya merasa aman untuk melepaskan Osmar berlari sekencang-kencangnya. Jelas Giorgio juga ikut serta ke taman ini. Kegiatan ini sangat penting buat anjing Saluki karena akan membantu perkembangan ototnya dan juga untuk melepas energinya yang tinggi. Semua jenis anjing, terutama waktu masih kecil, kalau energinya tidak dikeluarkan bisa jadi bosan di dalam rumah dan punya tendensi untuk merusak. Satu hal lagi yang penting adalah melatih anjing waktu masih kecil untuk belajar tinggal di dalam kandang kalau saya sedang tidak di rumah. Melatih anjing kecil perlu disiplin dan konsisten. Banyak orang yang merasa kasihan untuk mendisiplinkan anjing waktu masih kecil dan akhirnya anjingnya jadi bermasalah waktu sudah besar. Awal tahun 2011, Giorgio yang sudah berusia 13 tahun terdiagnosa dengan masalah slip disk dan radang sendi akut. Dokter hewan yang sudah saya kenal lama menyarankan supaya Giorgio disuntik mati dengan tenang, karena ini yang terbaik. Terus terang, ini adalah hal yang belum pernah saya jalankan sebelumnya. Tetapi ini adalah hal yang sangat, dalam tanda kutip, manusiawi di dunia binatang. 4 tahun kemudian, untuk kedua kalinya saya harus lakukan hal ini terhadap Osmar di tahun 2015 ketika dia berusia 10 tahun dan terkena kanker. Ini merupakan pelajaran baru dalam hidup yang membuat saya berpikir sangat dalam. Bukankah lebih manusiawi jika seseorang yang didiagnosa dengan penyakit yang terminal bisa memiliki pilihan untuk tidak memakai alat bantu hidup? Orang itu mempunyai pilihan untuk membebaskan dirinya dari siksaan, mengakhiri rasa merepotkan orang lain, dan juga melepaskan biaya pengobatan untuk penyakit yang tidak bisa disembuhkan lagi. Selama beberapa bulan, saya tidak punya hewan peliharaan karena saya merasa perlu waktu untuk diri saya. Hingga satu hari, saya menemukan peternak anjing Saluki di daerah Maryland, sekitar 1 jam dari rumah saya. Dari hasil pembicaraan beberapa bulan, akhirnya saya mendapat informasi dari jenis nama peternak anjing tersebut kalau dia akan menternakan salah satu anjingnya. Disinilah saya mengenal istilah co-ownership, yang artinya kepemilikan bersama. Hal ini cukup baik untuk kedua belah pihak. Misalnya, kalau saya harus bepergian jauh dan cukup lama, seperti pulang ke Indonesia selama 3 minggu, saya bisa titipkan anjing saya ke jenis. Karena anjing saya adalah anjingnya dia juga. Atau seandainya ada apa-apa dengan saya dan saya tidak bisa merawat anjing saya, anjing tersebut akan kembali ke jenis dan bukan ke tempat penampungan binatang. Perjanjian ini terdengar menguntungkan untuk saya, tapi dengan catatan anjing ini tidak boleh dikebiri karena bisa dijadikan prospek untuk jenis sebagai stok perkembangbiakannya di masa datang. Anjing Saluki kedua saya datang pada bulan Maret 2016. Saya beri nama Iksan. Pada bulan Februari 2017, anjing Saluki berikut hadir meramaikan rumah dan saya kasih nama Imran. Komunikasi antara saya dengan jenis berlangsung sampai saat ini. Melalui jenis, saya juga mengenal 2 aktivitas, yaitu dog show atau pertunjukan anjing dan lure coursing, yang merupakan pelajaran baru buat saya. Kalau orang ingin mempunyai anjing dan bertanya kepada saya selalu menjawab sejujurnya bahwa tinggal di Amerika dan memiliki anjing bukanlah hal yang mudah. Disiplin, konsisten, waktu, dan kesabaran amatlah sangat diperlukan. Memilih jenis anjing jangan karena bentuknya saja, tetapi yang paling penting adalah apakah anjing jenis tersebut sesuai dengan gaya hidup seseorang? Karena ini akan berhubungan dengan beberapa hal seperti fisik, waktu, dan finansial. Masa hidup anjing hanya berkisar antara 6 sampai 15 tahun, tergantung jenisnya. Tapi ketergantungan anjing terhadap pemiliknya akan sepanjang hidupnya. Banyak orang berpikir memiliki anjing seperti memiliki anak dalam hal tanggung jawab. Bedanya memiliki anak kecil tanggung jawabnya lebih berat karena mereka mempunyai masa depan, sedangkan anjing tidak. Untuk saya, anjing bukan hanya hewan peliharaan tapi juga teman hidup. Tapi satu hal yang indah adalah jika manusia bisa memiliki kemampuan untuk mencintai satu sama lain tanpa syarat dan batas, seperti cintanya anjing terhadap pemiliknya, mungkin dunia ini akan menjadi tempat yang lebih damai untuk hidup.
The next one will be the English version of the story. After living in DC for 4 years, in 1998, Ewan really wanted to have a dog. At that time, he diligently did research and read encyclopedias specializing in dogs. At the end, he fell in love with a breed of dog called Saluki. But because Salukis have a high activity rate, and at that time he was still doing his master's degree while working, he decided not to have that breed of dog just yet. Besides, he still lived in an apartment, so he decided to get a dog that fit his lifestyle, which was an Italian greyhound, which shape is like a miniature greyhound with a height of about 25 centimeters. Around the summer of 1998, from his research, he found an Italian greyhound breeder in Nebraska. His first dog in America was named Giorgio, an Italian name as it was an Italian greyhound. After 8 to 10 months later, he decided to get another dog with the same breed and named him Giacomo, who at that time was already 4 to 5 years old. In 2004, he moved to Columbia Heights, DC. In 2005, his dog Giacomo was diagnosed with a thyroid problem. At the end, in March 2005, his dog Giacomo passed away. Both Ewan and Giorgio were very sad. During that summer, he started looking for another dog. The Saluki breed that was once on his mind surfaced as an option. He did online research and found a Saluki breeder in Kansas. That was how Osmar, a white Saluki dog, came to his life. Saluki is a breed of dog which has hunting instincts that relies on its eyes, instead of its nose like other dogs in general. This breed of dog can run up to 64 to 80 kilometers per hour. Historically, Saluki dogs have been around since 7,000 years ago in Persia. That is the reason why many people living in the Middle East or West Asia have this breed of dog as their pets until now. The first people who had Salukis as their pets were the Bedouins, a native Arabian tribe who lived a nomadic life in the desert. These dogs have a slender figure with long legs with a height of about 70 centimeters. Ewan was highly dedicated and committed to his Saluki. Living in a big city meant that he could not bring Osmar to a fenceless place and let him run freely. Every time Osmar saw a squirrel, for instance, his hunting instincts would take over. At least twice a day, every day, rain or shine, he had to bring Osmar to a dog park during off-peak hours. The dog parks always had high fences, so Ewan felt safe to let Osmar run freely as fast as he'd liked. Obviously, Giorgio also came to the park. This activity is very important for a Saluki dog as this will help the development of its muscles and also to release its pent-up energy. All types of dogs, especially when they are young, if they are not given a chance to release their energy, could end up feeling bored at home and would have destructive tendencies. Another important thing is to train your dog when they are puppies to be able to stay in their kennel when you are not at home. Training puppies requires discipline and consistency. Most people don't have the heart to discipline their dogs when they are puppies and end up with troublesome dogs. Early 2011, Giorgio, who was 13 years old, was diagnosed with a slip disc problem and acute joint inflammation. The veterinarian whom Ewan had known for a long time suggested that Giorgio be euthanized peacefully as that was the best treatment for him. Honestly, Ewan never experienced this before, but this was the most humane treatment that can be given to an animal. 4 years later, he had to do the same thing for the second time with Osmar in 2015, when Osmar was 10 years old and had cancer. This was a lesson in life for Ewan that made him think deeply. Isn't it more humane for someone who is already terminally ill to have the option to not prolong his or her life using life support machines. People should have the option to free themselves from the pain and suffering, to not want to be a burden to others, and also to not have to bear the medical cost of an incurable disease. For a few months, Ewan decided to not get another pet as he felt he needed time for himself. Until one day, Ewan found a Saluki breeder in Maryland, about 1 hour away from his house. From a few months worth of conversations, he finally was informed by Janice, the dog breeder, that she would breed one of her dogs. This is where he learned the concept of co-ownership, which means both people own the dog. This is to the advantage of both parties. For instance, if Ewan had to travel for quite some time, such as going home to Indonesia for 3 weeks, he could leave his dog with Janice, as his dog was also Janice's dog. Or should anything happen to him and he could no longer take care of his dog, the dog would go back to Janice and not to an animal shelter. This agreement suited him well, with one condition that the dog cannot be sterilized, as Janice would still have that dog as a breeding prospect later on in the future. Ewan's second Saluki dog arrived in March 2016, and he named it Iksan. In February 2017, the next Saluki dog joined his household and was named Imran. Ewan's communication with Janice lasted even until now. Through Janice, he also learned about the two activities, which were dog shows and lure coursing, which was a new lesson for him. If people who are interested in having dogs came up to him and asked, Ewan would always answer truthfully that living in America and having dogs is not an easy thing. Discipline, consistency, time and patience are required in abundance. Choosing the type of the dog must not only be based on its physical features, but the most important thing to consider is whether that type of dog fits with one's lifestyle, as this would be highly related to a few aspects such as the physical activities, time, and the cost that are required. An average dog's lifespan is between 6 to 15 years, depending on its breed, but the dog's dependency on its owner is for a lifetime. Many people think that having a dog is like having a child in terms of the responsibilities. The difference is that having a child is obviously a much bigger responsibility because we need to prepare them for their future, whereas a dog does not. For Ewan, a dog is not just a pet, but a living companion. But one beautiful thing to think about is that if only humans have the capability to love one another without any conditions and reservations, like the love of a dog to its owner, maybe this world would be a much more peaceful place to live in. This is a story from Bagus Permadi Himawan, closely known as Ewan Bagus. He is originally from Jakarta, Indonesia, and has lived in Washington, D.C. for 26 years. He currently works as a professor and a photographer. For those who grew up in the 80s and 90s in Indonesia, you might recognize him, or might also be one of his biggest fans, as a well-known model who frequently graced the covers of various top magazines. This is one of our special editions as we face COVID-19 pandemic. We'd like to extend our deep condolences to those who have lost their loved ones. This is definitely a very difficult time for everyone, and we can only hope that soon we all heal as nature flourishes. Probably one day when we look back, we learn how valuable is the time that we have to hug our loved ones, to be kind to our fellow humans, and to thank the sun for shining upon us. I'm Natasha, your host of Speak Indo Podcast, and we would like to thank our guest speakers for sharing their story. If you like the story, please share it with your friends and family. The transcript of the story is available at our blog speakindo.life and our YouTube Speak Indo channel. You can subscribe to our channel so that you won't miss any upcoming episodes. Thank you for listening, and let's share positivity.